Welcome, Unicums and soon to be Unicums. I'm OKVator, and today I'll be showing three games in the E50M. The first game will be on Dynasty Pearl, and right now I'm just going up to the typical med spot. I just told my whole team to go left. Right at this little crack is an awesome place to get first shots off. I end up getting a shot into Leopard. Actually a pretty lucky shot because I zoomed out before I took the shot. I have the 62A with me right now, so I'm starting to move up a bit because I have a guy with me to take some hits. I see the 1-3. Get a shot into him. Our 62A is moving up. Looks like he's kind of suiciding into the whole enemy team. So right now what I'm doing is I'm just taking advantage of his suicide push, and I'm just poking out to get extra shots to Leo. I get a pretty lucky shot to the 54 right now. And right now, I'm just kind of waiting for my team to move up, and mainly for the enemy team to move up, because since the enemy team has an advantage, I know that they're more likely to push up than my team. So in these type of situations, it's best to just hang back, sit tight, and just let the enemy team move up. This IS-4 is a perfect example of just waiting for enemy teams to move up. He ends up poking across and getting absolutely punished for it. He's at half his hit points now, and 183 is pretty much dead. So what I'm doing right now is I'm just moving up. The main thing that I want to do is take out this 183. I honestly should have taken that shot there. I don't know what I was thinking. I just want to make sure that I took him out, because if I missed and he hit me, that would cost me my rush, because at the moment I'm rushing into pretty much a full health 54 and an IS-7. As I move up though, I do realize that this 54 is behind the building. That's one thing I didn't realize beforehand. So right now I realize I can just push on this IS-7. I'm trying to bait some shots into my tracks right now, and as this 54 reverses, I get shot by him and shot by the E75. So since I'm at such low hit points, I decide to kind of side hug this E75 to try and bait some shots from him. Just like that, I reverse, get a shot into his turret, and now I'm trying to get to his side. I get a shot into his turret with heat, and now just gets absolutely demolished. I end up taking the victory with 4,488 damage, 480 damage blocked. I end up taking the Confederate medal with 15 shots fired, 15 shots hit, 14 pence, which is exactly what you should be going for in every game that you get. Make sure that you hit your shots. Every shot that you miss is potential damage. On to the next map, Normandy. I just tell my team to go towards the right side. Unfortunately, they end up splitting off. So right now, I'm just going towards the med position to try and spot some guys crossing. I see the E5, get a clutch shot into him. And right now, I'm kind of confused because I see the IS-7 pushing to the dip. I see the E5 pushing towards the left. And as soon as that 62A gets spotted and the bad chat, I know that most of their team has split off towards the left side. So this IS-7 that you're about to see get spotted pretty quickly right there. I'm about to go with this VK-72 and rush him. The reason why I was so hesitant for a few seconds is because I did not know where their two tier 10 tank destroyers were. But as soon as I saw them spot on the left side, I knew that I could push this IS-7 with our VK-72, poking over this ridge, get a heat shot into him, because I don't want to risk bouncing an AP shot. I know that I need to kill this guy as soon as possible because my teammates are dying on the left side. And as soon as you see his badge hat that's about to rush this IS-7, right there, I know that we have three guys on the right side and there are only four guys on the left side against six of the enemy tanks. And right now I'm just booking it as fast as possible. I do know that there are 268s unspotted, but I'm willing to take that risk. Even though this bad chat isn't going forward and spying him, I do love this HE shot into this 62A 513 roll. That just made my day. And now, I'm just going for his E5, shooting HE into him. I'm trying to see this little dip that I'm in. It's kind of covering me from any possible tank destroyers that are in their spawn on the right side. So right now I'm just pushing this E5 from this dip, knowing that their 268 isn't spotted yet. And I'm just pushing forward with my team. I see that this E100 isn't looking at me, so I take this as my opportunity to try and get behind them again. This flash ends up getting a shot to me. I know this E100 has a few seconds left. And right about now, I know that he's just reloaded, and luckily my teammates finish him off. Now look at where this enemy 268 was. Even though he was unspotted the entire match, I still kind of narrowed it down to know where his general location was. So if I had not gone to that dip when I pushed that E5, I would have gotten a shot from this 268, and I would currently actually be dead right now. But it's just situational awareness like that. And as I ran this guy and shoot him for a combined 617 damage, definitely one of the highlights of my night. Let's see how much damage I do. 4,732, 1,222 base XP. Look at that. 13 shots fired, 13 hit, 12 penned. It's all this potential damage that you guys have to make sure that you get. Like, just make sure that you hit your shots. It makes a difference. On to the next map. Himmelsdorf. I tell my team to go towards the left hill. I have a couple meds with me, so I know that I can afford to play a bit aggressive. I see that they have a pretty good player on their enemy team in the STB1. He's from Grimm, so definitely someone that I have to look out for. As I see him coming towards me, you guys are gonna like this shot. Look at this. Look at this shot. Capola shot. Boom. 365 damage. He pokes on me, bounces heat, and this shot is enough to make him run for his life. Now just watch the shot. HE right in his rear. 445. That guy's night has just been ruined. They're 140. I know he's almost dead. They're 62A. Yes, I snap a shot to him. I do end up taking two shots in return, which might not have been worth it. That shot made me so annoyed because I know that I should have switched to APCR, but I kind of held my shot, hoping for that HE roll. And as soon as I see this 183, my heart just stops. that shot, that bounce, just made my night. I'm honestly having such a fun time in the E50M. Ever since this guy is buff for the gun depression, it's just made this tank even better than before, because with its hull armor, it's angled so much that you can just bully meds, you can bully heavy tanks. 183s bounce off you, and this IS-4, most broken tank in the game right now. Just that slight little twist of his tank made me bounce a perfectly great shot, which in my opinion is pretty stupid. So now I'm rushing this IS-4. I'm just trying to get as much damage as I can, because I know that the enemy team is almost dead. They have two tanks left. I end up getting a max roll on that guy. Just amazing. This Yagi 100, I see him pushing the IS-7. Unfortunately, he ends up getting tracked, and instead of seeing him push forward and being able to get a shot into him, he ends up dying. Almost got 5k. 4,465 damage, 1187 base XP, 16 shots fired, 15 shots hit, 14 penned. Just an end to a great night. Hope you guys are having a great day so far. I'll catch you later. Bye-bye.